Hey, nerdlings.
What up, nerdlings?
Do you nerd for things that go bump in the night?
They're doing things they've never done, hoping that it's lots of fun. Oh, they're nerdgins.
All right, so recently we got to check out something that was in our hometown called the Paranormal Cirque. And this is a traveling act.
It is a traveling circus style, burlesque style.
Cabaret, vaudeville. It's just like a mishmash.
And it's, you know, old school circus under the tent kind of thing, which is really cool for me because I don't know about you, but I have never been able to go to a circus in a tent.
Speaking of the tent, you love the way the outside looked.
I did. It looked so cool. I really loved. They had, you know, like the big beams on the side that was holding up the sign that said Paranormal Cirque. But then hanging from that was like skeletons, which was really cool. And then they had like this like half decapitated zombie on the, they had a big wrought iron fence on the outside and there were zombies hanging off of it. So it was really kind of neat. It was very Halloween-y. So I thought that was fun.
Now, as soon as we walked in, they did have an area just kind of for fun before the show, and they were having a lot of fun out there.
They were. There was, right outside the little tent, there was a truck that was the, like, the food vendor truck, and they had the typical, you know, the Don't Dead open inside on the side, and it was really neat because everybody that worked there was painted up kind of macabre, scary-esque, and so I think she was a nurse. Once you walk past the food vendor van, you go inside the little tent, and that's where they had a bunch of other food trucks inside and the merchandise that you could buy, like t-shirts, and they were really big into the mask, like the masquerade style masks, and some of them lit up, some of them didn't, and they had horns that you could buy, like devil horns that lit up, and t-shirts, and all kinds of fun paraphernalia.
Now, the only reason you didn't buy anything was because there were no prices on anything.
Correct. And I don't know, somebody with a scary mask on is a little intimidating sometimes. You don't necessarily always want to talk to them.
Of course, like I said, they were having a lot of fun in that little tent area. Whether it was somebody hiding under the table and reaching out and grabbing someone when they were walking by.
We had a lot of fun standing off to the side and just basically watched that for about a minute or two, just watching people, you know, jumping and scaring. That was fun. There was also a guy walking around with the stereotypical chainsaw.
Of course.
And, you know, ring, ring, ring! You'd walk up right behind somebody you didn't know they were there until he rev that engine and he was screaming, and it's like, are you screaming to scare me or are you screaming because the chainsaw's so loud you can't hear anymore? But yeah, he'd walk up and he'd just yell right in your face, you know. I won't do it so it won't hurt your little earsies, but yeah, he was fun.
And there was somebody zipping around in a chair and they were done up almost Mad Max.
Yeah, they were. They were Mad Max style. This person was really, really good at controlling that chair, because there was a few times that I was like, they're going to crash. They are going to crash into that person, and they would literally stop, like, this far from them. I'm like, that's impressive.
Now, moving past the little tent, you can't have something paranormal without...
a smoky cemetery!
Which, actually, it was pretty neat to walk into that part because it helped to sell that ambiance that you were going into a creepier area. You know, outside was the fun. This is where it's getting serious.
Yeah, and they were using black light in there, and the black light really made the smoke really look really, really cool. And then, of course, there were more actors or performers, I don't know what they want to be called, that were in some form of scary Halloween-looking kind of esque masks or makeup or whatever. And then off to the side there was a really creepy, I didn't get too close because I didn't really want to look at it, but there was a cage with someone in it laying on a table screaming. I think they were disemboweled and somebody was taking some sharp object and smacking the cage and making loud clanking noises, and I didn't want to go over there.
Now, we were not there just to hang out in all of the pre-show areas. We were there to get under that big top. And we are admittedly cheapskates.
Yes.
So we got the cheap seat tickets. However, they were pretty decent.
They were. It was kind of, there wasn't a bad seat in the house because since it's a big top, you can't get too tall. And you can't get that far away. So even though we were literally on the last row at the top of the bleachers, it wasn't really that far.
So right before the actual the show began, they did have some people walking around in the audience. A small clown that was freaking quite a few people
out.
He was
really creepy at first. I didn't like him because I don't like clowns anyway. And he would come up to you, and he would just like.
Oh, he would do all kinds of things. He would do more than just stare.
But I mean, he would just stare at you and keep going. He would mess with you. He especially, like, of course, you know, a good performer will do this. He loved to mess with the people who were very obvious afraid of clowns. And there was one girl there that I remember watching her, and she put her purse in front of her face, and she'd go, no, no. And then she'd put her purse down and go, no. So yeah, that was funny.
Of course, there were a trio of teenage boys right in front of us.
Uh-huh.
And he came by and he did just the creepy death stare at them. And you could tell it was messing with them because if you watch the backs of their heads, they are doing everything in their power to not look at him.
Well,
oh, look at these beams over here.
I'm sure their mother told them not to stare at strangers, you know, so they were just being polite. That's what they were
doing. Right.
There was only one problem with the performance, and that was...
They did have a sign up asking for no photography and no video. So, unfortunately, we don't have anything from the actual show to share.
No, but we thought we would still tell you what we thought about it. And then in the descriptions below, there's links to their website so you can get tickets or find out if they're coming anywhere near you. And if you go over to their Instagram page especially, they have pictures and video that they posted themselves, so you can get kind of little snippets of what they've done.
First and foremost, they started off the show with some acrobats kind of dressed up as zombies, and they came out and they started doing... they weren't really uneven bars, but it was kind of the same style.
It made like kind of like a cube square thing, and they were really, really impressive.
Now, of course, you know, to do some of your fun audience engagements, it helps to have that plant.
It does,
out there.
Yes.
And this guy, he sold it well.
He did. The little clown did a little kind of like comedy joking around with the spotlight on him, and he had a microphone so you could tell the show had started, but he would start messing with audience members and everything. And this is where he kind of became less creepy and kind of cute, because he's like, he would just walk up and be like, hello, hi, hello, and then he just kind of became adorable. But then he found this one plant guy, and he was trying to get him to come up on stage, and the guy acted like he could not speak English at all. And the clown kept saying, what's the matter? You don't speak English? Well, come on. And so then he would start doing motions, like, you know, like this, but for stand up, and come on stage with me. And it was funny because they both were pantomiming because they were pretending they couldn't understand each other. And then he gets him on stage and does all these things, and then it kind of went from there, and he took over the show, so you could tell it was the plant, but he did a really good job.
Now, something nice, of course, was that there was a good variety of acts mm-hmm. to watch. You know, they started off with the acrobatic act, they went to the plant. A little later in the show, just before the intermission, they actually did this comedy routine, and it was funny, but it lasted just a little too long.
Yeah.
And I don't know if that was, like, the performers kind of stretching it out, or maybe if it was the people... the non-plans that had been brought up on stage. But I think the whole crowd was kind of, you know, they still thought it was funny, but they're kind of like, okay, let's get to the next one.
Yeah. They, as far as the paranormal aspect of the show, they started out, the first performers, the trapeze guys, they came out and acted like zombies. And then the plant guy got bit by the zombies and he became a zombie. But then they kind of got away from the paranormal
for
a little while.
Good portion of the act.
And, you know, the plant was the main comedic guy, and he would do a lot of different comedy acts and everything, and then some other performers would come out and do some things. They did the big, like, I don't know, it's not a hula hoop, but it looks like a giant hula hoop. It's just a big giant ring, and that was a neat act to watch the guy, you know, spinning around and not, you know, doing all kinds of acrobats with the rings. But I think one of our favorite performances was the silk dancers.
Oh, definitely. If you guys have ever seen one of the shows with someone that does the silk kind of flying around the stage where they wrap themselves up, this one, now we've seen a couple. We've seen a couple of circus shows even out in Vegas.
Yes.
And, you know, just around at our own circus and everything. But this one, I'm going to tell you guys right now.
Took the cake.
100% sure this guy could actually fly. And I think that he was just kind of holding the silks to make it seem like he wasn't actually flying.
Yeah.
Because I'm pretty sure that he told them, you know, oh, I can really fly. And they're like, no. If someone finds out you can fly, they're going to chop you up into pieces and find out why you can fly. Hold on to the silks. Make people think it's a trick. But yeah, I mean, the strain. You ever watch a silk show? Watch that muscle strain.
Yeah.
And you will see them, you know, holding on because you think, oh, they're just holding on to silks. Oh my gosh, I can see them straining. That is difficult. There was no strain from this guy.
A lot of times, you know, you'll see them, they'll wrap it around them and then they'll do that run and jump and then fly around in circles. Well, there was one time they did it. I kid you not, he literally had a hold of the silks like this and was just flying. And I'm like, he's just there. So, I mean, that was by far my favorite part of the whole show. The burlesque part of the show started when some scantily clad ladies came out, basically in, like, you know, sparkly, spiky bras and underwear, and they were running around the stage dancing, and those were vampires. And so they were attacking the main comedic guy, and they were trying to suck his blood and live off of him. And then out comes the vampire queen. And this was a very tall, like, wearing horns and scantily clad, and she bites him and throws him into a coffin, and he spends the entire intermission in the coffin.
Now, during that intermission, which was about 15 minutes, the whole time that coffin did not leave the stage, but they did bring out a throne. They had some of the masked and makeup actors come out and, you know, pose for some fun pictures and everything. Everyone got to run up there real quick and get some fun photos.
Now, I will say, like I said, I was very impressed because the guy never left the coffin. It was 15 minutes there the whole time. And when intermission was over, the vampire queen comes out and does this little thingy over the coffin, and it opens, and he stiff-board stands straight up. And I thought that was really impressive. I was like, that's cool. And he completely had changed clothes. He now has completely different face makeup on. He's got creepy contacts in and fangs. And so it's like, obviously, he was doing a quick change inside the coffin. And then the last half of the show was basically magic.
Yeah, and there were some great illusions there. Some really impressive ones, which this is definitely a shame why we can't show you some video from it. Because, I mean, they were having hollowed out boxes with the sheet up, and they would have one girl come out, and then two girls come out, and then three girls come out, and it's like, okay, it's hard enough to try to picture how one girl was fitting in there. How did you get three girls in there? And not that I need to know that trick.
Oh, yeah. Watch it.
But it was some very impressive magic, and it was a lot of fun. And unfortunately, that part went so fast.
It went way too fast.
Do some more.
Yeah, it went way too fast. And then when the show was over, they all, very kindly, all the actors and performers went up front, and you could take pictures with them. So that
Of course we did.
Yes, that was really awesome and really neat. And it's really kind of funny because I didn't realize how short they all were until Tom went up to get his picture with them. Because I go up there and get my picture. They're all the normal height or whatever. We're just thinking, oh, the vampire queen's just really freaking tall, man. Maybe she's got really high heels on or something, you know. And then I was like, all right, Tom, your turn. He goes over there and I take the picture. I'm like, nope, vampire queen's normal height. They're just short.
All right, nerdling. So, of course, we couldn't take any photos or video for the main show, but what pictures and video we could get, I've tried to drop into this video, and there will be links in that description down below so you can go see their pictures and their video to really get a feel for this. And like she said at the start of the video, check them out, see if they're coming anywhere near you, and consider going to give them a watch. So, of course, if you happen to like the video, leave a like. Drop some comments down below. Be sure to subscribe and hit that notification bell. We never know what we're going to be doing next, which is why you guys never know what we're going to be doing next.
Don't forget to like us on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram so that you can see where we're going next, because somebody's got to see where we are. And don't forget we have merchandise over on TeePublic and Nerdlings. Even if it's paranormal, if we like it,
we nerd it. Was that an honest reaction?
But people are gonna know you grabbed my ass. Yeah. But it was impressive, let me tell you. I'm not going to tell you, because that's all I got to say. Sorry guys if that offends you. I'm short, it's okay, we're all short, it's fine.
And I guess that's all we got to say about that.
I didn't know you were gonna bump,
we're closing this up.